Все может получиться.
Sportbets.com – уникальное место для настоящего геймера. Только здесь возможны ставки на киберспортивные события. Ты знаешь толк в самых популярных играх и готов рисковать? Смотри регулярные трансляции и зарабатывай реальные деньги. Sportbets.com – живой азарт и холодный расчет.
And welcome back, everybody, after a commercial break and also a great song by Ludacris that I feel I can personally relate quite a bit to. But now we have Epsilon versus ESG. Best of one game, the final one of the evening. And thank you for tuning in. Of course, you're watching Room on Fire with myself and Semler. And we are just about ready. We do have half the players on. We need the other half still, though. Semler, what's going on?
I'm watching Newbie win the international.
Yes.
Oh my god, that's it. They've done
it. Wait. Who was it that predicted this? I can't remember. Did I say Newbie was going to win? I may have done that.
Oh man, this is it.
Damn. Sick stuff. Those guys are going to win, what, $800,000 each, basically?
No, they
or
win.
Is it even more than
each.
That now?
They win a million each.
Yeah.
It's 5 million total prize. They win $1 million each.
Yeah, well, even if the team takes
the team takes what, like, if the team takes like 15-20%, yeah, okay, you're looking at 800 grand
yeah,
each.
That's what I that was just
after
what
taxes,
I was assuming.
You're probably still sitting on like what, 500 grand?
Exactly.
Hopefully, you know, give or take.
Yeah.
It's not bad.
What are the viewer numbers like? That's what I'm really interested in.
Well, they have 230 on Twitch, but I have no idea how many people are watching in game and I don't know.
ESPN.
It seems underwhelming not to see more numbers than an average LCS day, but
yeah, that's what
on
I'm
Twitch,
thinking.
You know. But it's like,
Oh well. I mean, it's down to timing sometimes. I mean, I do think if you'd had one Western team and if Alliance or Na'Vi or something would have been there, it would have been maybe a little bit different. But you can't control stuff like that. I have to say I've been trying to watch as much of the international as I can. I really enjoy Dota. I think it's a really fun game. And I think that the quality of games overall has just been really, really high. Whether you get the best game in the finals, can't really control that, can you?
No, that was pretty good. The last match was, I like how everybody in chat was basically saying that that VG got Brazil'd. Because that last match wasn't even a fight. It was just Newbie completely demolishing them. But that was a good series. Newbie, to pull that off after an average group stage, to get all that way and just dominate throughout the playoffs, that's insane.
Well, hopefully we can have some great French action coming out here against the Swedes soon. Shoxylon playing up against ESG. I don't think you can actually stop that term from happening anymore, Semler. I mean, I think you're right. You have a really good point that there is no such thing as just having one person win a game. Even if Shoxi goes 30-0, it'll still be in large part due to his team helping him out a lot. But it doesn't matter. That term is now unstoppable.
Shoxylon?
Yeah.
It's such a good
term as well.
I'm still all about the 30 frags, one Shox.
There can be only one, which used to be a cheat code in Warcraft, I believe.
Yeah, I think you're right. Yeah, but that's like old Age of Empires stuff too. Like all your base are belong to us. Like, that's the only one that I really remember. There was also like the one where you got like the Mustang, the Ford Mustang with a rocket launcher, and then the little guys with the ray guns. I can't remember how to get those though.
Wasn't something with Kid or something? I can't remember. There was a... I never played much Age of Empires, I have to admit. I remember the Doom cheat codes, like, you know, IDDQD and IDQFA and KFA and stuff like that. Yeah, just all those cheat codes. So I still pretty can. I even remember
you cheated, Anders?
I even remember the... Well, everyone cheated. It was single player. I even remember the Wolfenstein cheat code was LIM. So if you just hold down LIM all at the same time, you get weapons and shit. It's great. Okay, that's enough. That just betrays how old I actually have become. So we'll just move on from that topic, and just remember that we played the ludicrous song because, you know, that's what I'm like. Now it's going to be 10 people on the server, and we are getting ready for it. It's going to be on Mirage, so we've been seeing nothing but Dust 2 all day, and now we get a bit of a change. So thank you to ESG and Epsilon for switching it up for us.
Yeah, exactly. A bit of Mirage to spice things up. We know that both of the teams are actually very good on this map as well. Epsilon, we saw it at DreamHack Summer, they had quite a capable performance, but ESG also, this is definitely one of their maps that they are very good at, so we are in for a very good match to finish the night here, no doubt about it. I feel like this is very even as well. I mean, I would actually put, especially after the team change here with Epsilon, you know, them dropping Mistu and bringing in FXYO, I would actually put ESG ahead. I would say ESG are favored in this match, but just slightly.
It's so hard to tell, isn't it? Because we've been seeing two different versions of Epsilon, and, you know, one of them beat Hellraisers on LAN, which is obviously a big thumbs up, great stuff. But the other one seems to be just, like, serial failing at all kinds of games. But now they brought in FXYO, so I really can't even really make a prediction, I feel like. It could be that that Epsilon come out incredibly strong, but I don't know. I think I'm going to call this one a 50-50 based on the fact that it's a best of one and it's online and it's a new lineup. So we'll see how it all goes. Welcome to the show anyway. It is the SLTV Starseries Season 10. And if you're watching us on YouTube from a VOD, then, you know, thanks for tuning in as well. And click that subscribe button on YouTube too. Remember to follow our channel here on Twitch. I hope you guys have had a good evening. We certainly have enjoyed your company and we're looking forward to this game. Similar, what's up? I mean, Epsilon, this they get to start on the CC side at least.
50-50, I would say it's like 55-45 ESG.
All right, fair enough.
I'll go wild, man. Put it out there.
Crazy. All right, fair enough. Maybe
ESG,
it is.
ESG, man. They're monsters. They're monsters. But they get the start, or at least Epsilon, they get a solid start here. They get to choose the CT side, so they will get the advantage going into the early game of this map, the first half, that is. ESG, however, T side, and already they really are putting up a bit of a fight here at mid. Smoke goes down to cut off the window, so FXYO can't really do too much apart from put some shots through, but he doesn't have the information now, and that's the important bit. ESG, they could be anywhere right now.
They could pretty much be anywhere, but they are, in fact, towards the catwalk, wanting towards the B bomb side, and a great Molotov coming out from GMX, putting ESG in a bit of an awkward spot. Now they're all funneling around this one side of the column down there, and SF is still up here. I mean, look at the rotation. Epsilon should win this round, no problem. Rogue picks up the first kill, and actually, this is fairly even right now, which it definitely shouldn't be. Shoxi goes down, and what the hell is happening? Kiyoshima is somehow alone in a 1-on-3, and I just have no idea. Mykilele just basically stole Shoxi's power and used them against his team and won that with a triple kill.
Mykilele's position. The fact that his teammates stayed alive on the site, but also that Mykilele was able to keep the high ground up in B apartments like that and just play it down to a T. Peeking gets a kill. Peek get a kill, right? You're just looking to support your teammates from on high. It's the eyes in the sky, right? But that was really big there from Mykilele. He just made that happen for his teammates.
Such a confusing situation. That rotation from Epsilon meant they should have had such a bonus going to that, but I guess you're right, that high ground ended up mattering a lot, and Epsilon maybe weren't able to quite coordinate a push there. Emilio actually catches FXYO, even though he looked like he had a really good position to Ooh. Pick a kill. Now Rogue is going to be maybe sandwiched in here?
GMX and SF have pushed really far into B apartments, though. It looks like SF is going to be the one who's about to run into a man. He needs to get this kill onto Rogue. Is Rogue going to actually manage to... They just dance. They can't actually do it.
The kind of reaction Rogue just gave was incredible, and he's going to turn around and run right into Shoxi. Rogue just can find no peace, but he actually comes out alive, so I guess that's good. But I think he basically had a heart attack when he ran a DMX then.
Yeah, pretty much. Pretty much. It was the dance, it was the surprise, it was that peekaboo moment. And somehow he lives through it. He lives through Shoxi as well. So Epsilon really not up to the best start here. I mean, they don't get anybody in that second round, which is definitely going to cost them. That's going to allow ESG to get quite a bit of money, and it's also going to make life pretty hard for Epsilon. But it looks like ESG, they aren't even wasting any time. They're just running straight out onto the A site. Full YOLO, and there's the spray. Emilio gets two, he gets three. and this is definitely ESG's round at this point.
Yeah, bomb goes down as well, and SF will pick off Delpan, so that's good, but Delpan didn't have a gun, he just had a pistol, so it's actually not that big of a deal. FXO is about to be found here, Mikey Lily checking one corner, checks the next corner, and that's where he is. Actually could have gone down, but it will be still another ground for ESG. 3-0 here. And right now, I mean, I don't really count these. I mean, obviously, three rounds matter here. But if you look at the scoreboard right now, it's 0 for Kyushima, 0 for GMX, and 0 for Shoxi. So I'm pretty sure that we'll be seeing a very different Epsilon in, you know, this round.
Yeah, well, they've got the rifles now. That's the big thing. FX is actually the one sniping right now, which is interesting here for Epsilon. So yeah, he'll be the one going glass cannon AWP. Getting out in quad, getting out in mid, or quad rather, connector, looking towards top mid, not really finding any targets, looks underpass, doesn't see anybody. We had a peek there from SF into B apartments. They can actually now have a pretty good idea that this is going to be an A play here from ESG. They've got so much information to go on, Epsilon. They aren't seeing anybody on the other half of the map.
Yep, so good work early on from Epsilon. If the push happens, they should have what it takes to deal with it. Kyushima and Shoxi up close here makes a really big difference. Smokes are going to rain in now. Not sure if FXO can actually find a spot to ult from. Yeah, he's smoked out, so it's going to be down to Kyushima, and he takes down Delpan, who tried to charge him and stab him with the AWP. Not how that weapon is used. Shoxi inside, takes down the bomb carrier. Now it's a 1-on-4 here for Mikey Lily. So great defense coming out from Epsilon, especially DMX here with a quick double kill. Mikey Lily, if he could get one more kill, it would be significant, but it's not. So overall, a fantastic round from Epsilon.
Yeah, just a solid hold, just textbook play, really getting information across the map. They ESG didn't even try to fake it. They didn't even try to throw Epsilon for a loop. They went straight over to A pit and set up for a smoke round, but Epsilon, they didn't wait around, you know, they didn't play it passively. They put FX in mid to get information, then he looked underpass, didn't see anybody, and then SF peeks into B apartments, doesn't see anybody. That's a lot of information for Epsilon to be getting unchecked. And it just allows them to make the right call and be on the A site when the play actually comes through.
Yeah, FXO still in the middle here. I really want to see him up, and he will take down Mikey Lily. So we got to see the first taste of the newcomer here on Epsilon making his mark on the game. And yeah, so if he's a strong opener and they already have Shoxi, they might have, you know, a bit of an ESG effect actually going on with Mikey Lily and Delpan, which is pretty cool.
Yeah, that's something to consider, actually. The potential for double op to be able to actually pick that up whenever you want. I mean, when you don't make it a habit, but it's really just, you know, when you decide to actually, okay, like, let's go for the double op and actually catch opponents off guard. That's big. FX point blank on the Emilio, though, will catch him through the box or just at the crack of it. And now that's a two-man advantage for Epsilon. Epsilon can now play passive if they want to and really just wait ESG out, force the clock on them.
Looking really good here for the Frenchman. I mean, yeah. Doing a lot of damage here onto Delpan. He's on 6 HP, goes for the peak again, and then tries to retreat, but it's pretty much too late. I think at this point, they might as well just try and save the rifles, because with 25 seconds, they're not really going to have an impact on the round, and they are going to be falling back. So, yeah. 0 kills in the round, well, 2 rounds ago for GMX, Shoxi, and Kyushima, and now everyone's picked up a kill. And that obviously makes a really big difference. I mean, that's, I think the initial 3-0 score looked a little bit I think if you'd read too much into that, you'd think that there was just the ESG winning all the way, but a lot of them had never really been put into play.
Well, let's see if Delpan can live through this. I don't think anybody's going to be able to close with him quick enough. Just barely run out of time there to find him. He only had like 6 HP as well, so could have been an easy kill there for Epsilon to clear the board. Now, look at this play from ESG. They're just forcing it. Rogue with the Deagle, but we have 3 rifles and some nades here for ESG. This is in third round where Epsilon are going to be under pressure. And ESG, again with the rush? Yeah, they're going... Are they going for it or not? They get up into pit aggressively. Delpan is here with the AWP. He needs to find a shot. Goes for the flick, but he's not going to get it. Shoxi gets the headshot first.
Yeah, second kill picked up from Shoxi. Actually, Delpan was aware that he was going to be up there, so pretty good reaction from Delpan, but it's just not quick enough here. And now they're just sort of throwing themselves at the remaining players. Rogue is going to be alone, and they are going to home hunting for him. They don't want him to save this ult. He gets the one kill. Could have been a really sick double, but at this point, it is all just a matter of playing out the round here. Rogue should not be given a chance to get anywhere near a bomb site. And they shouldn't let him keep this orb either.
No, they're going to box him in. You can already see the rotation coming out here from GMX and SF. They get right into T-spawn. So now, Rogue, he has nowhere to go. And there you go. He gets caught in a crossfire at the end. Epsilon, as soon as they got rifles, it was a totally different beast here. This is impressive. The fact that they're able... I mean, FX is having a big impact right now. You're talking about an Opper who's second in line for the most frags on the map. And Shoxi, Choxy is definitely landing some shots with the headshots. He's got 6 frags to his name right now.
Yeah, and that's going to be ESG ecoing. So the score is tied at 3-3 now. ESG are on the less favored side. I think if they can get up to 6 rounds, they're going to be happy. If they get more than 6 rounds, they're going to be celebrating it. So I think it's on Epsilon to have this kind of start. It's good that they were able to bring it back, and now they just need to keep soldiering on, and they could be in line to take this one. And I think it'd be... I'd be really, really cool for the French scene in particular, but also for the global defensive scene in general, if this Epsilon team really starts working well. That'd be super exciting.
Oh, 3 top teams?
Yeah.
Hell yeah. That'd be sick. I mean, that puts you on par with Sweden, pretty much. So that's...
Oh, yeah.
That's an accomplishment when you're talking CS and Sweden's obvious history there.
And it's a lot of fun because we already have LDLC and, you know, Titan fighting it out. And if Epsilon joined that mix and start to you know, really make a big dent, then all of a sudden we just don't know what's going to be happening. I'm excited for this.
I mean, if you look at it, in the end... the end of DreamHack Valencia was pretty much LDLC and Epsilon fighting it out, and LDLC just barely getting out ahead.
Yeah.
So that was close, and LDLC are a team that are capable of taking out Titan. I mean, they've got Apex. I think he's got the best record versus Titan out of any pro player, pretty much, is that he's just Titan killer. So, I mean, Titan, they're top. Well, I think for a while now, their position on the throne has been threatened, and I think if they're still on it, they're just barely hanging on to it.
Yeah, I agree. It's hard, though. I mean, you know, once you're on top, it's like Game of Thrones. You learn so much from watching Game of Thrones, right? One thing is conquering, another thing is ruling. So, mm-hmm. Titan, they made it to the top, at least in the French scene, but it's kind of hard to stay there. Everyone's gunning for you. And yeah, Epsilon and LDLC are definitely 2 contenders. Now, if you didn't actually see the grand finals of DreamHack Valencia, you can go onto our YouTube. The link is at the bottom. And you can go and pick up the game there. We have all the VODs up there, and all the VODs from previous SLTVs, and most importantly, the VODs from our Case King tournament last week, which featured some incredible games. That was so much fun. And this week, we have Epsilon playing, so we're pretty excited about it. We have Hellraisers playing, which is going to be insane. Hellraisers got knocked out of DreamHack Valencia by Epsilon, so they're going to have a chance to avenge that that loss. And then one of those two teams is going to be facing against Na'Vi, which is this week's King of the Hill.
Exactly. Although it isn't going to be the same Epsilon, so that's going to be interesting as well. The fact that FX is now on this team replacing Mistu, that just happened today, if not yesterday, whichever, but very recently, since the team got back from Valencia. So we're going to have, a rematch per se, but it's not going to be the same lineup, but it's still a rematch because it's pretty much the same teams. Regardless, it's going to be a sick match because Hellraisers are going to have something to prove. Like, they have to just put Epsilon down.
Yes.
And get rid of them. That fluke, that 16-0 final map where Shoxi just went completely demented and ruined everybody, like that needs to be proven that it was a fluke and that Hellraisers are not going to be taken lightly.
Well, it's kind of hard to deal with, isn't it? Shoxi just going all crazy like that. And you know what? I don't know if this is one of those evenings, but I met Shoxi at the DreamHack Summer. Yeah, after party.
Yeah,
And everyone was getting kind of drunk, and Shoxi's a very, very friendly guy. If you have a chance to meet Shoxi, just go and say hi to him. He speaks English perfectly fine. He's just always a little bit shy when it comes to interviews, but there's no reason he should be. His English is really good.
It's a very French thing. It's the accent.
Yeah,
they just don't want to talk because they think their accent is horrible. And I'm like, dude, I'm having a conversation with you right now. You speak perfectly fine. Like, why aren't you the one doing the interviews? Why is it always MBK?
What's really funny is I think some French accents can sound maybe a little bit comical or maybe a little bit annoying even, but Shoxi has a really, really charming accent. Like, there's no way you can't love Shoxi if you listen to him speak, so there's no reason he should be shy at all. But he told me actually that his father sometimes tunes in and listens to the cast, and he's a big fan of the stream. So I don't know if this is one of those evenings, but if Shoxi's father's out there, then shout out to you as well.
Bonsoir.
Exactly.
Merci beaucoup pour votre fils.
We don't know. We could be giving random shout outs to someone who isn't there, but he said it. He tries to do it as much as he can. Obviously, we're waiting for Shoxi to get back in the game. A bit of internet issue, and he should be back on top here. A lot of money for Epsilon, I'm just noticing here on the scoreboard. Look at this, 11,000, 10,000, 9,000, and 7,000. So it's a big task ahead of ESG if they want to eventually force an eco for Epsilon.
Oh, right now, Epsilon aren't out of the woods quite yet. As far as Well, Epsilon. I mean, Epsilon are actually, they take four rounds in a row, do it in pretty damn fine fashion, and they've got a disgusting amount of money. I correct myself here. It's ESG who really are under a lot of pressure now. For the first three rounds there, they actually managed to have quite a bit of a bank where they were able to put some good force buys in. But this is where they actually have to kind of step it up and put Epsilon down. The problem is that they've already used a go-to strategy that is kind of like your oh shit strategy, where you're like, well, we're having some trouble just getting the picks. We're not really able to get control of mid, for example. You know, we're kind of running into a brick wall. Let's go for a smoke round, right? Yeah. And then that's kind of like your go-to play where it's just like, okay, we're actually having trouble. We're just going to go for a smoke round and see how that works on A site, right? Because that's a pretty good strategy to use. And if you execute it well, like, you're going to be able to get on that site and get that plant, right? Epsilon have already just demolished it twice. So ESG at this point are probably scratching their heads wondering, like, what now? What do we do now? Because we've used this strat. It hasn't worked. Do we just keep using it? Do we keep banging our heads against the wall? Or do we try and go for a B smoke play? Like, what do we do?
It's tricky because I think in that last play that we saw where Shoxi was up on the box inside this A bomb site and Delpan was going for the peak there, I think if Delpan actually gets that flick, there's a very good chance ESG just outright win the round because the last two players are in a sort of an awkward position. Like they get trapped towards where Shadow is, and it's all right being in shadows when you have someone either inside the bomb site or over towards connector or over towards the CT spawn. Someone who can basically, you know, draw the attention away from the terrorists. But if you're just there alone and, you know, they're coming in from all angles, it's a really, really bad spot. So that could have worked out differently, and maybe ESG are just thinking, okay, next time we get the pickoff and then we're good to go, we'll win. But if they keep thinking that and they don't actually do it, it doesn't really help them that much. We'll see. The game is resumed again, and we'll see if they're able to do it. FXJ already flashed a fair bit. A lot of flashes ran in. So, yep, they're running towards that wall again. Let's see if it's going to be a brick wall this time, if they can knock it down. FXJ and Shoxi stepping it up. Shoxi does go down. FXJ charging in. CSET 75. Oh, what a sick play. It does turn it into a 2-on-1 now. Michael is seeing if he can take down another player and maybe win it. Now 1-on-1.
Michael, definitely one of the best players on this team, ESG. He's one of their heavy hitters. And this is a situation that he can win. Flash comes out, and there's the spray. He catches GMX out on the edge of the smoke. Very nicely done there by Michael, keeping his cool at the end there. How patiently he looked to find SF and then didn't miss the opportunity. Just very nice play there. But that was a real... I don't know about... like that's FX, I think, just getting like really overconfident. Him going in there like that.
I'm sorry. Somebody just described called Shoxi's father. Well played, sir. Well played, sir. That's very funny. FXJO goes down in the middle. Not something that's going to make him smile. I'm sorry. I'm losing my composure. Delpan is not. He's going to pick up some sick kills in the middle and open up the whole map. And this is what it means to get those entry frags. I mean, last time we saw what it mattered, Delpan almost takes down Kyushima, but Rogue is actually in a position to just walk in here. And I don't think Kyushima is going to be spotting it. Rogue maybe a little bit too slow. Yeah, just 1 second off with the timing. And Kyushima's still alive.
Oh. And Shoxi gets caught. Cheeky play there. The boost from Michael. Michael with the spray, and he lives with 2 HP. This round is falling apart for Epsilon. Epsilon now. Kyushima finally strikes back. Picks up one. Can't get the second, though. And the plant, in the meantime, is happening over at the B site. He's been boxed in. Kyushima, nowhere to go. He throws down the smoke. He looks for the fight, but Delpan will get him. That's 3 for Delpan, 2 for Michael. And you're talking about the two guys that need to be getting frags on ESG. They finally wake up and get another round on the board here for the Swedes.
5-4, and Epsilon can still buy. That's the result of having that big bank that we were talking about earlier. But that has sort of disappeared now, and that's a big problem here for Epsilon. They got to make sure they keep winning, and FXJO doing a fine job making sure that'll happen. Kyushima running up to the middle, but he actually gets picked off. Backup wasn't quite there quick enough, and FXJO goes down as well. Now, I don't know. It's still a 3-on-3. They haven't lost this round yet, but... I think they could have got a lot more out of that mid-push.
Yep. Now things get hairy, though. As they're having to try and rotate guys around here. GMX in a bit of a cheeky spot over in window. He's looking to see if anybody's going to be coming up connector. That's a good little crossfire position right now between the man holding and connector, Shoxi, and GMX. They could really catch ESG in a pinch. But it's going to be GMX peeking out. Gets one. He almost gets the second. Rogue just barely makes it around the corner. But he's going to walk right into SF, who's waiting on that B site. And Shoxi striking from behind. He's going to get another one. Tries to click it, but it doesn't happen.
Pretty sick spray control from Emilio. I'm wondering if that's if that was like just crazy or if he really thought he had that under control, because that looked insane. Now he's going to be walking basically right into DMX, who's actually just playing this one really smartly. A lot of credit to DMX for playing it this passively, because he knows Emilio has 35 seconds to pick up the bomb and then go to a bomb site, so he's no reason to peek or do anything. As long as he can keep an ear on him, he'll be all right. Emilio charging for the bomb, and SF is getting the information from DMX. DMX just telling him right now, yeah, he's running to short. They have such a good control of what's happening right here, and it's kind of a delight to watch, actually. Emilio tries to make the jump over, but I don't think he can actually win this round much anymore.
No, at this point, he's going to be too pressed for time to be able to check this site thoroughly, and if SF plays this right, 10 seconds left, Emilio, he's just not going to have the time. SF just waits for the plant, yeah, and Emilio has no choice at that point. He has to run onto that site with the bomb out. It's just not meant to be.
Yeah. So that kind of communication is a really rare glimpse for those of us watching who aren't on their TeamSpeak or whatever to understand a little bit about how Epsilon communicate. And even though it seems like a simple thing, I mean, even if you're like, you know, global elite in matchmaking, you'd probably be able to do this kind of communication with two friends playing together. But it is really important that they're able to do it, that they don't just, you know, go for the kill or anything like that. Playing the clock and playing it intelligently. It's nice to see that kind of style.
Exactly. But again, we have a bit of that. I mean, ESG are really putting a lot of focus on mid right now. But the thing is that ESG are now knocking at a good finish. I mean, they're knocking at the door. And on the other side of that door, just waiting to open it after like another round is a good finish, a solid finish to this first half.
Yeah, I know if they lose this round, though, they will be echoing. But you're right. They are close.
That one. But they, you know, ESG right now, if they get six rounds in this half, I think they'll be happy. Their CT side is very good.
Yeah, Rogue has actually picked up a Tech 9, so I guess that's also an option. Maybe not the worst option in the world. FXGO going to be peeking into the middle, takes down Mikey Lily, which is great news. That was a very important kill. He had an AWP as well, and FXGO did not, so that could have been a battle he could have lost. SF's waiting over here for Emilio to maybe peek his way in, and he's going to make a jump. I think he may have didn't spot him, actually, and almost goes down to Emilio. Really quick shot here from the Swede, and now are they going to go for the B-bomb sign? That's the question. FXGO picks up one more kill. Right now, it seems like he's a great addition to the team, although Emilio will pick up a kill inside the bomb sign. DMX ready to see if he can return it, and he has the right timing and the right angle, but can't find the kill here, and he's going to go down. That was unfortunate.
This is quickly falling apart here, but then Epsilon, they still have two guys with full HP. Shoxi and Kyushima are closing in. They're right here on top of the site, and he turns away. Shoxi misses an opportunity to pick off Rogue, but he still picks off Emilio, gets two. Now Shoxi is in a great position to pick up the last member. It's going to be Kyushima doing the majority of the damage. Baits him out, and Kyushima, with the perfect fake on the defuse, draws Del Pound out into the open and gets the sixth round for Epsilon.
Very fine retake from Epsilon in a position that they could have lost. I think they could have also won it earlier with DMX in that bomb site, because it looked like he had some really good timing, but he just didn't. He think he did almost enough damage, but he was just like 10 damage off. And if he had got that kill, that would have probably been the round even earlier. But nice retake from Epsilon, again keeping their composure. Now we're at 6-5, moving into the 12th round, and ESG, they get the bomb line, which is sort of good news, but they still can't buy.
No, they can't, exactly. The money isn't really there. It is going to come down to, the end of this half. There's still four rounds left, though, so there's still opportunity here for ESG to turn this around and get that sixth round, which would be solid for them, which would be solid. So they are going to go for the straight B push here. GMX and SF just shutting it down, though. There isn't really anything happening here for ESG. A perfect hold comes out for Epsilon. And now Epsilon, I mean, money actually is back a bit to normal here. They actually do have a bit of a bank saved up. But at this point, it's not really... I don't know if it's really about that anymore. It really does seem like ESG is just about rounds. You don't really care if you just have the rounds on the board.
Yeah, I think you're absolutely right. ESG just want to win one more round and see if they can do that. Forcing Epsilon to eco right now is definitely sort of a second rank priority. So we'll see if they can get in here and do that. They've shown that they are able to do it, but now they're still going very aggressively, which, if you remember how passively they played on Dust 2, it's definitely a big switch up here for the Swedish team to be playing this fast on Mirage now, because they basically only pushed when there was about 40 or 30 seconds left on Dust 2, and on Mirage, they're going all in. FXGO, though, with an incredible flank here. ESG gotta move so quick, and they are moving quickly, but they're losing a lot of members. Kyushima does go down, but I still think FXGO can win this whole round alone with this particular push. But
you can.
What?! 1 HP, Emilio does go down, but now Shoxi, well, it is Shoxi, so this is not over yet. He's looking for the kill, he's making a lot of noise here, and walking out, Rogue takes a lot of damage. Now Delpan has to try and cover him here, and Rogue's just got to stay in his spot. No reason to peek any longer.
Epsilon's got, I mean, Shoxi, he does have the kit to work with here, but he just goes jumping straight out into Rogue. Rogue with a great position there, holding right below Van. That was also good communication from ESG, and if played correctly, a nigh impossible situation for Shoxi to come out on top of. So really well done there for ESG. The fact that Emilio was so very low, that kind of, I think, gave ESG a stronger chance at the retake with Shoxi getting that easy nade kill. But after that, the crossfire was set up, and it would just take a Shoxi play basically to make it happen.
Yeah. FXGO has an AWP peeking out into the middle and looks for a kill, can't quite find it, and he's got to be careful, and he will be careful just running back here. I think if you replay that last round 100 times, this would be the one time where FXGO doesn't win the round because of his position, basically. Like, that shot from Emilio is so ridiculous. Mike Lilly gets the one kill and doesn't have time to pull out his weapon for DMX, so just a quick trade. A one for one, as we call it, and FXGO is going to pick up one as well. Now it's a 4-on-3.
Well, FXGO is now swapped over to the B site, and he's making it work. Two kills already to his name. They're finally going to be able to pick up the bomb here at ESG, but they've only got Emilio and Delpan left. Delpan, with that AWP, though, could actually find a kill mid if he decides to take a peek. There's both members here for Epsilon, one in window, and the other moving back in through connector. Trying to just cover ground at this point, but 45 seconds left on this clock doesn't leave ESG with a whole lot of time to work with. They are going to have to make a decision as to where they want to go pretty soon.
Yeah, 40 seconds is definitely not a lot, but in a 2-on-4, I mean, what are you going to do here? They probably will have money to buy in the upcoming round. No, actually, they won't have a lot of money to buy in the upcoming round, so they got to be really careful here. Some spray right through that wooden panel, which you now can shoot through, but Kiyoshima's crouched behind, so he's not going to get hit. Delpan still takes the kill. Now Shoxi is in the bomb site, M4A1 in hand. Delpan creeping around the corner, and he just takes him down like it's nothing.
Yeah, Delpan just point blank, doesn't even need a scope. It's all good. He gets too close for it to matter, and now he's looking towards CT. Goes for a shot onto GMX. GMX isn't going to make it happen, though. Delpan should be able to pick him up. It's Emilio who gets the kill, and now it's FX alone. 5 HP, gets the parting shot on Emilio, but he's just too far away.
Yeah.
He's too far away to be able to make this defuse happen at this point.
Yeah, now he's just on the ladder contemplating life, wondering about all the mysteries in the universe while the bomb goes off across the map. And yeah, you're right. He has, you know, $350, and upcoming is the last round of the half, so he's going to have to just use this AWP like, as well as he did this round. Your triple kill is nothing to scoff at. Somehow Delpan actually dies with the bomb, which is... Oh, actually, just... No. Who died? Somebody died with the bomb. It wasn't Delpan. He just got killed by FXGO, but somebody else died with the bomb, so they don't get to save anything.
Delpan. Emilio got killed by FXGO. Delpan was just sitting, staring at the bomb. A little bit weird. It seems like everybody is kind of... Well, there's Shoxi. What's going on?
Shoxi can win the round. Just push the CZ spawn or the T spawn and you'll be good.
Well, three of the members for Epsilon, I think their ping just jumped up a whole lot.
All right, so internet issues. We've had them before, so once it's been reset, we'll be ready to go on. Sorry about this, guys, again, but it does give us some time to advertise all the stuff we've been advertising all evening. Remember, if you go to the bottom of the page, you can click the Facebook link down there, and you can participate in the raffle. It's a picture, so you just click the picture, and you go, and you click the like button, and then you can win all sorts of stuff for our own Case King of the Hill tournament, which we're looking forward to on Wednesday. You can also go to our YouTube channel and check out all the VODs, including everything tonight.
Yeah, everything is there. I mean, we make a point now of having the VODs loaded up after the broadcast. So if you happen to miss a match earlier on in the evening and you don't want to go hunting around in the Twitch VOD for the timestamp, we have everything right there. And everything from here on out, basically, that gets casted on this channel will be posted there immediately. So it's a good little... We're really trying to put together... Well, the good library, really, you know, where you can find pretty much everything you want. It seems like we've lost everybody on ESG. So I'm not really too sure what the hell is going on at this point, but
I'm not sure.
Unfortunately for us.
Well, in the meantime, we can. I'm just reading hltv.org here, and it seems like Refuse are now called All In, with the lineup Insta, Llama, Tobacco, Percy, and Glaze. So names, at least three of them that are fairly well known in the Danish team, and I think Percy and Glaze we sort of recognize as well. If you're keeping a close eye on the Danish team, you'll know who they are. So yeah, a new Danish lineup coming out. Interesting to see how that's going to fare. But obviously, we have some more severe issues here that we need to deal with eventually.
It seems like we might be just changing servers here. So everybody is disconnected from the server. We may actually have a bit of a wait while they get a new server sorted out. The score was 7-7, I believe, between both teams. Not really sure that FX could have done anything about that position that he found himself in. So yeah, 7-7. And the last half, I can't remember the money situation, actually, between both of those teams. If Epsilon had enough to really put something, put a fight up there.
I think they had, I mean, they would have saved the AWP, and I think they had two more people who could buy, but I think they would have had to have two pistols. That's, from memory, that's what it seems like to me. So we'll see. I am sure the admins are on it and know what they're doing. So again, apologies for the situation. We're just talking to the SLTV admins to figure out what is going to be happening. All right, so apparently it's just a, I don't know, some sort of internet issues. Apparently, it's not even like a DDoS, they're saying. They're just having like a general malfunction. So we'll see what's going to be happening. We'll be right back as soon as we can. In the meantime, if you guys want to click the follow button on the stream and subscribe to us, we definitely appreciate it a whole lot. Shout out to Devilwalk in the chat, who's always here spying on us, but never joining the stream.
Mm-hmm.
Devilwalk, if you're on Skype, you can just join the call right now. We'll bring you in.
Oh, Devil's here?
He's in the stream chat, just like, you know, not even doing anything.
Is he just trolling?
Yeah, I'm going to see if he's on Skype.
He probably is.
I mean, why not? We'll see. If he wants to, we don't want to put any pressure. He could be doing all sorts of cool things. You know, we never know. Maybe he has a girlfriend over, or I don't know.
A night off from prac?
Whatever the young people do these days.
Why is it one? Is it Monday? Yeah, it's Monday today.
It is Monday.
It's kind of bad when you forget, like, you start getting lost in which day of the week it actually is.
I don't worry about what week it is anymore.
Yeah, let's see if we can get him in here. Impromptu TriCast.
Just, you know, peer pressure and all that, forcing Devilwalk into the game.
Let's see.
He's super excited.
Hello?
Hello, Devilwalk.
What's up, Devil?
You know, nothing much. I just looked at TI4 and came back to the computer and watched the only game I saw was live. So, jumped onto stream.
Excellent.
Watch some Counter-Strike.
Well, yeah. We really appreciate it.
Gotta do it.
It's nice of you to come on, especially now that we have a bit of a delay coming up here. It's nice that you want to come and hang out with us. So, what do you think of ESG? I guess you have a little bit more experience with ESG being a Swedish team.
Well, we Swedish teams usually don't really prac that much against each other. They usually stay away from each other. So we haven't really in the past, or I haven't seen the new Fnatic lineup practice against them at all. But I know from experience that they're a solid team. They won against us at DreamHack Summer, so obviously they're a strong team. And if I'm not mistaken, are they like second in the SLTV Starseries right now?
They're at least pretty high up there. I don't think they're quite second, but they're up in the score right now. They are amongst the highest.
They are second right now. 6-1 and
right.
One.
Yeah, you're absolutely right.
Yeah.
So there it is.
They've won against Virtus Pro. I think they
took out Hellraisers as well.
Yeah. They're obviously a strong team, and I think from previous experience, I know for a fact I would be scared facing them on Mirage. They have a very solid T side and usually have a lot of rounds bunched up. In that side, and it makes it easier for them going into a CT side, obviously. But their T side is the strongest on Mirage, and I was surprised seeing they actually played Mirage since it's a veto system. But yeah,
well, we're kind of glad we've been seeing Dust 2 all evening, so I guess they saved us from another Dust 2 game. I've just been updated from the admins telling us that that they've just rebooted the server, and then we should be good to go again. So hopefully not too much of a break here, guys. Again, thank you for staying with us and not just leaving everything behind. So what's up? What otherwise is going on? I mean, how do you feel about Shoxi's performance here during DreamHack Valencia Devilwalk?
I saw like the stats. I didn't actually watch all the games. Just followed the news, followed the stats between games. He's obviously been amazing. That's kind of what you've been used to seeing from him as well. So I'm not really that shocked that he's putting out these scores. You usually...
Oh, did we lose Devilwalk?
Are we losing Devil?
I'm here. hearing nothing but static.
We've lost Devil.
Oh no. The DDoS is real. Everywhere it hits. Yeah, we'll see if he's going to be back. In the meantime, we are obviously just like reconnecting in. I was excited to hear what the conclusion was of that Shoxy story, but we couldn't find it. I think it must be Olaf Meister, because he's calling him a noob co-caster in chat as well, so...
I think it's just Devil Walk trolling us.
Oh!
He was giving us...
I have tunneled Skype, so I get these lag connections sometimes, so I don't get DDoSed.
All right, fair enough.
I see. I thought that this was just like some kind of meta troll or something that you were trying to pull off, where you were about to tell us something really interesting and then just cut off. And then horrible things would happen because we'd all be waiting and we'd never get the answer.
Oh. We'll see. I'm looking at the admin chat to see what's going on, but they are just saying that they're going to restart it and we should be good to go. But yeah, Shoxy has, you're right, I mean, he has always been really strong. It's just that, I mean, did you notice his Devil Walk as well? When he was out of Titan and just moved into Epsilon, he just felt like a completely different player. Like, he felt like he was playing really, really horribly. The Devil Walk Skype call.
Why do you have a tunnel now for Skype? You don't need it anymore.
All right. He says he's going to try and get his laptop and see if he can set it up for that, and then we'll see how it works. Sorry about that, guys. But I guess it's kind of cool that he's protecting himself at least. Protection, kids. It's pretty important when it comes to Skype and everything else as well. Now, this map just reloaded for me. Does that mean we're about good to go? I can't take this anymore.
I think so, because now at least, I'm getting a loading bar. And loading bars are good, right? Because things happen at the end of loading bars. Yes, okay.
We've been trained to assume that, but now we're on the wrong map. I mean, it'd be weird if they played the second half on Dust 2 instead of Mirage.
They're trolling us. They're like, okay, well, we got kind of tired of Mirage now. We feel like we heard that you guys liked Dust 2, so we're going to give you more Dust 2.
Imagine like what a weird tournament you can have. It could be fun to do just one day where you play. If you win the half, then you get to choose what map the second half gets played on, and then you just kind of play like a best of five in that format, and it'll be really weird.
Dude, can you imagine right now? So it's like, okay, ESG, they get 7 rounds on the T side of Mirage, and then they're like, okay, cool, for our map that we're going to play CT side on, we want Nuke. And then you're just like, well...
Well, you could probably come up with a system to prevent people from doing that, so it's like you get to choose the map but not the side or something like that. It's all... That could be some weird stuff. I don't think we should put like a lot of resources into it, but just it's a thought experiment.
You get stuck, like, imagine you get stuck playing T side twice. How frustrating would that be?
How
I guess if you got stuck playing T side twice and your second T side was on Dust 2, you wouldn't actually be that annoyed. You'd be like, okay, yeah, we can deal with this.
Maybe. Still just waiting, guys. Again, we do apologize for this weird delay. We are sort of at the end of the first half with. I don't know, actually. I think ESG do have the upper hand. I think the score is going to be 7-7, and then we're going to be playing the last round of that half, and we'll see how it goes. Either way, I think even if it turns out 7-8 in favor of Epsilon, it's still a pretty good result for the Swedes.
That's a very good result. We're talking about a CT-sided map here, and ESG getting a couple rounds, that could make all of the difference. All of the difference, because imagine they pick up the pistol round, how hard it's going to be for Epsilon to fight back from that. Right now ESG have got to be very happy with their performance. I mean, I was saying that maybe, you know, like if they get 6 rounds, they're going to be very happy. Like that's going to be a very good performance from them, but getting 7 rounds on the T side, that's starting to get into the realm of, I'm starting to think about putting on the hat to give Epsilon a helping hand here, because they just might need it going into the second half.
Do you have the hat nearby?
The hat is right here, man. The hat is never far away.
Oh, well then there's still hope, I suppose. It can always be changed.
Well, you know, for the low, low price of an Asimov AWP stat track,
I need something like a token like that I can pull out for the Danes. But I don't know what it would be, because if I carry around bacon in my pocket, it's going
to
be really weird.
You get a pack of bacon.
Like I think at tournaments, that's definitely going to cause an upset eventually. Some kind tournament organizer is going to be like, Anders, I appreciate you being here, but the bacon just can't happen anymore. Leave it at home. All right. Oh, Kiyoshima joined. Or actually, well, he got kicked because he has no Steam log on. But there is some sort of progress definitely going on at somewhere in the world. I can promise you that much.
There's movement. There's movement. We've spotted them in their natural habitat on Dust 2.
I guess I could have, like, Legos or something in my pocket.
Legos?
Yeah.
That feels like, that sounds like it'd be really uncomfortable, though. You just have, like, pointy Legos rubbing at your leg all day?
And a little bit weird. I pretty feel like I was, you know, in like, you know, trying to seduce children or something, you know, running around with toys in you. That's just weird. No, don't want to do that either.
Hmm. I'm not sold on the idea of Legos. Bacon is much more fun because at least, you know, you're walking around, you get a mite bit peckish, you got a snack in your pocket, right?
Can we just make it a beer? I feel like that's... That has some purpose, actually, as well. You know, Danish team is losing, you crack open a beer. Which, actually, when Danish teams lose, that is what they do anyway, so it kind of does make sense.
Well, that, like, Copenhagen Games is, like, the perfect example of that because they actually have beer in the venue and the teams are just, like, drinking between matches.
Exactly.
How does that... I mean, that's, how does it get more Danish than that? I think, actually, you're right, man. You should have, like, a... You know those camelbacks? You need to have a camelback with beer in it, Anders, and then you're just gonna, and it's gonna have like a little Danish flag on it.
Well, so the first land that I ever went to for casting purposes was with Risk over in Jutland for the Blast, and he told me before we went, he said, "Well, part of the point of going to Danish lands is kind of, you know, if you win, then you drink to celebrate, and if you lose, then you get to drink earlier than everyone else." And that's part of the reason why people go. And I sort of thought he was just like, you know, trying to make it a little bit more interesting until I actually got there. And it's exactly what happened.
It's exactly what happens. Just like, okay, we're out of the tournament. Sweet. Walk 20 feet to the bar. Get cheap beer.
That is pretty accurate.
I love Copenhagen Games.
Scary, scary stuff. Yeah.
I do love beer as well.
Oh, you do love beer.
You're back.
Yes.
Nice.
I'm back.
You're like one of the only guys on Fnatic that likes beer, though, because I remember the rest of your team just drinking like fizzy, like tropical drinks and stuff like that. It was really weird. I think Schneider had like a pink drink. I was really taken aback.
Is that why he's off the team now? Said just can't, you know, it's about reputation. You just can't drink any old thing, like, you know, sends the wrong impression. I can understand that.
Especially Schneider. I mean, Schneider, you know, he looks like he could beat you up, right? Like, you know, he's got that eye, you know, the eyes, right? You know, and then I mean, he's a really nice guy, don't get me wrong, but like, you know, the way he looks sometimes, just like, I'm gonna murder you. And then you know, you walk into the bar and he's got like a pink fizzy drink in his hand, and it totally ruins the image. I was like, now I don't know what to think.
Yeah,
I think, hey, now we're on Dust. How about that? Let's finish it.
oh. We're back on Mirage with people on it. Unfortunately, Devilwalk keeps like connecting and disconnecting, which is unfortunate. It's not like he got super offended. We've already been joking about, you know, everything, so it's going to be all right. But I wanted to throw that in there. A little bit of... Actually, if you guys didn't know, we've already been having this discussion about Schneider and Fnatic and everything else. We had it with Thorin over at OnGamers, so you can always go and check that out, that whole show.
Okay, now. It should work. I think I was disrupting with having two Skypes. Simultaneously run.
All right.
Interrupting each other. So it should be fine now.
Okay,
fingers crossed, man. Fingers crossed.
All right. Is there any way you can turn up your microphone volume a little bit, Delvor? Because then you might be a little bit lower than the game.
Might not be, actually. Let's see.
Oh, now my game crashed. Everything is coming together tonight. It's just beautiful.
Well, as your game crashed, everybody died on the server as well. So.
Okay.
But one thing that's good is that they were actually able to recover the save status from the game. So it was 7-7 right now. It looks like Delpan, you know, Delpan died, but they do have money on ESG to actually get a pretty decent buy-in. Brokus guy is like 4,200, so they do have a very good buy going into this ESG. Over on Epsilon side, however,
you don't have to actually turn the volume up, though. They people saying it's fine, so don't even worry.
What the hell just happened? Okay, bring it back. There we go.
Okay, I'm going to switch it over to the game. Then once I've connected, I'm just waiting. Are you actually still on the server?
Okay, yeah, I'm in.
Okay.
But right now, FX managed to hold on to his AWP, and Epsilon, it's kind of a mix. They have two guys who could get a pretty decent buy-in. One of them is going to have to use a FAMAS, though, so that's not going to help things.
All right. I'm connecting back in as well, and with a little bit of luck, we'll be back in the game right here and see if we can get it on.
We're still paused.
We're still paused. All right.
We're still paused, so don't worry. There, you know, you have Falak. You don't have to rush too hard.
All right, great. I'm just gonna quickly switch around some settings because I always forget to put these in my launch thing. So there we go. Now I'm definitely ready. So again, we do apologize for all this nonsense, but I think we are about to be ready with the last round of the first half here. And we do, I think, still have Devilwalk with us. So what's up, Devilwalk?
Yep. Just exciting to see how they decided to get this last round sorted out. Did it actually reset the whole one-on-one situation to a whole new round, or
no? They let them win it.
Decide. Okay.
I think they win it because they're putting it at 7-7 right now.
Yeah.
With FX, he still has an AWP. Delpen, unfortunately for him, is dead.
Yeah. Yeah. I think that's the right call as well. I think this is what it should be. So now we're just sort of waiting, seeing what's going to be happening. Obviously, they're trying to restore, and sometimes for
what
reasons that nobody knows, you have to restore a lot of times.
For what?
Sometimes it bugs out and one dies.
Ah.
Now, I think Kiyoshin was dead for a while, and they had to reset until he was alive.
Nobody knows what's happening, but it is happening. Now we're getting ready. It's going to be unfrozen. 7-7, and the last round of this half coming up. Epsilon versus ESG, SLT Star Series Season 10. And in the middle of everything, we've got Devilwalk from Fnatic joining us. So thank you very much, Devilwalk. Really appreciate it.
And no problem. Yeah.
Oh, well, there's FX actually starting off strong, picking up Delpan. So that's advantage Epsilon so far at the beginning of this half. ESG aren't wasting any time, though. They're going straight up short. In fact, they aren't slowing down at all.
Oh, all over the place. GMX just narrowly, by the tiniest pixel, managed to miss Mykelele, and that got him killed. Now SF has to stay alive up here, and he's going to get a kill as well. Oh, great play from Superfighter. That leaves Emilio alone and probably secures the round. He's actually going to pick up the last kill as well, so really strong defense. But if he had gone down, then it could have been a pretty uncomfortable situation, I think, for Epsilon. But 8-7 for the first half. Who's the favorites going into the second half here, do you think, Devilwalk?
Oh no, did it stop working? Did we lose him again?
I'm actually just cursing. It's every time I ask a question, it doesn't work anymore. I'm so sorry, chat.
I don't think so, but let me see. Well, he's still in the call, technically.
It says so. Alright.
I'd say that ESG have a pretty firm lead, however, with the number of rounds that they've managed to get.
Feels like it, but it is exciting, isn't it, to see FXGO as the latest addition coming in with a 15 kill lead here. He's actually top fragging the whole game right now, so that's, I think, really good.
He's just, he's just had an excellent performance. Like, this is, I guess, the first live match that he's having with the team right now, a first official, and he's already putting in a hell of a lot of work. I mean, he's top fragging on the map right now, and he's played AWP for the majority of this. So it's interesting to think that it's like FX who's really had a big impact, but then that Epsilon aren't able to get more rounds on the board when their AWPer is the guy who's top fragging.
Yeah, we'll see if it's gonna change. I think we need a lot of games to evaluate how well he fits into the lineup, but based on this one game, it's looking pretty good. A quick rush towards the B bomb sign, and they actually slow down, even though if they had kept going, I think Rogue would have been in a pretty uncomfortable situation. He does have a Molotov, but generally those don't actually work so well to stop pistol rushes. Now he's gonna peek again, the Molotov's gonna come out, and again, I don't think Epsilon are gonna stop for this. Did he keep rushing in? It does some damage, and actually, oh, great pick off there. Rogue mid-air, and also Kitten, who can actually just wait for backup now. This is not a good position for Epsilon. They don't have the bomb plant. They're running in, SF taking damage while he's trying to see if he can maybe clear the way for the bomb to go down. It will go down, and it's a 4-on-3.
Oh, and there's a great headshot from Kiyoshima. SF gets one as well, and this is falling apart now for ESG. It looked like they were in a favorable position, but this is just not panning out. Delpan with the headshot. He needs to get more. Kiyoshima still alive over on short, holding up this push from ESG, and there's the flank. FX even gets a knife on Delpan.
All right then, Delpan trying to see if he can buy time to reload, didn't get the chance and just goes down. So there it is. Really, really good comeback from Epsilon in that one round. I think ESG had a pretty big advantage going into that retake.
That was definitely a big round for ESG to throw away, in a sense. I mean, it seemed like they were able to get two very quick frags before even get out of the apartments, and then they kind of just got shot in the face a whole bunch of times, and Epsilon somehow found a way to get out ahead and even get a knife in. That's just adding insult to injury. And guess who got that knife? FXGO. So not only does he like dominate with an AWP, but then you know he goes like double phallic and picks up a knife and shanks you with it too.
Yeah, pretty good stuff coming into the 17th round where we're at now. ESG not going to be buying any kind of armor, but they do have P250s and a C-set 75 on Rogue, so can still dish out some damage. They are trying to go a little bit aggressive, but if they do, Kiyoshima is here to hold down the T-spawn, which is a very cool idea. And actually, now they're all going to be coming. It seems like Mikey Lily might actually end up in a great position, but he keeps jumping, and Kiyoshima hears him, and that's the end. If he had stayed, which he really couldn't know that he had to stay there, but if he had, it would have been fun.
Would have... I mean... Right now, it's just kind of down to ESG moving around the map, throwing their weight around, seeing if they can catch somebody off guard with pushes like that. So I like that Epsilon, they keep a man back here to just make sure that there can't be any of those pushes. Right now, Rogue, though, with the C-75, wait, then, gets overwhelmed. Rogue picks up a gun, but he's not able to get anything done with it. And now it's Emilio getting caught over in connector.
There was like a lot of times that I think Rogue should have died, but that last man wasn't the time he should have died. It was really weird he couldn't pick up that one kill, because that should have been an easy one. But he was under a lot of pressure, so maybe we can just forgive that one. But even if he had, there's no guaranteeing they would have won the round. But still, it's pretty good for ESG. I mean, they get some damage on the board here. They cost Epsilon some rifles, and now we're into the 18th round where they still can't really buy, and they're going to lose a man really early on. Emilio trying to see if he can take up the fight, but Kiyoshima controlling the spray really well. It's going to be down to Delpan to pick up the first one. P250 in hand still. He's looking for one more shot, but it's not going to happen.
No, it's not meant to be. Hoiten is now going to be the last man alive, and he gets caught by FXO. So a pretty solid follow-up round here by Epsilon, keeping nearly everybody alive. Only Shoxi getting caught in the end. So the money is going to start getting a bit out of control here for Epsilon, whereas ESG, they get the double AWP play. Now this is very interesting. This is why they don't go for pistol armor in the second round. They decide to go hard eco and just get as much money as possible so that they can do something like this.
Oh, Delpan is there to pick up the first guy, so they were trying for a really quick push, but it's already been severely handicapped. Emilio trying for a flashbang, bit of a trick, but it doesn't actually work all that well. And luckily for him, they weren't pushing that much. They're going to fall back Epsilon, which is actually not a bad choice, I think.
No, try and reset. Try and reset the situation. Decide to go back now.
I'll be listening for you guys.
Okay.
For 2 minutes to check everything's all right. And it seems to be right now, and
All right, good stuff. We'll see if it's going to hold up or not. Always happy to have you, Devil Walk.
Always happy to be here.
Now, let's see.
Smith.
I mean, they're going for mid-control right now. Delpan is looking the right way, but he's got to be careful when he falls back onto the stairwell that he doesn't get shot through those wooden panels. He's got to remember that that's actually a possibility now, and he actually just falls all the way away, giving up a lot of controller connector here. That means they could kind of walk in, but smoke goes to ramp, and he's going to be in a good spot as well.
FX just point-blanks with Tendo. That was sick play. That was awesome. The no-scope right there into Whorehouse manages to clear up short. Now the rotation comes in from Mike Lilly, however. He jumps out in time, and he gets the headshot onto FX. Gets the follow-up. No, does not manage it. Rogue will get one, drops the bomb carrier, but it's just not falling, not going ESG's way here.
So 2-on-2 retake. I mean, who has the advantage, do you think, Devil Walk?
The terrorists should have the advantage. I mean, they keep playing, play the angles, just hide. Important thing is... Delpan has to try to force them to rotate from that position, so Emilio maybe gets a flank shot, but playing it good.
Yeah, pushing in. It's going to be hard now for SF. 24 HP. They need to find him before they can put this bomb. They can defuse this bomb, and he's actually still staying alive. SF gets the kill, and now he's just ringing around the rosy here. Emilio can't catch him. He does, but he doesn't have a kit. He's going to try and pick one up. It's a little bit too late, and
oh,
I think
man.
He just may have had it in the last second.
He has it.
Oh my god, if he had spent one more millisecond finding that defuse kit, that would have been all over. That was very close, Devil Walk.
Yeah, I think actually Epsilon could have played that a little bit better. But, I mean, they got into a really good position, taking over short, already being a man down, and forcing the push short. And it seemed like ESG had very slow rotations, actually, to the B site, but they were ready for the retake. They could probably have stopped it earlier, the actual push. With Epsilon pushing like three or four guys just straight out of short. They lost a man early, so they should have had the information.
I just didn't react in time on it, apparently. But they still are able to pick up rifles here. And Epsilon, they do have a three-round lead. So we'll see if it's going to continue this way or if ESG are going to come out on top. Emilio gets Kiyoshima as he sort of runs backwards through the smoke and just gets sprayed down. They don't have a lot of control over connector right now, but I guess Mikey Lily is keeping an eye on it, and FXGO survives that shot. Delpan, I don't know what that was.
That was interesting, I suppose, is a way to put it. It seems like Epsilon are gearing up for another short push, though. Right now, the bomb currently sitting right around, right around the room on short, and they are kind of like scoping up, looking for any of the members on the ESG bomb site. But both of the members for ESG are holding so very passively at this point. They don't want to give anything away, despite the fact that they only have two rifles to work with here, no AWP. So they're going to have to land some stellar shots here, ESG, if they want to stop this.
And Delpan is holding a really good position right now, just covering this from an unlikely angle. FXGO has been really good so far, but this is not easy, and he will go down. And now this push towards the A-bomb side is really not looking good. Emilio, with a good pickoff there, takes down Shoxi of all people. DMX has fallen, and SF is left here in a 1-on-5. And actually, they won't have a lot of money in the upcoming round, Epsilon, so things aren't looking too hot, but SF is still making things happen.
Yeah, there was 6 seconds left on the clock. I almost wanted to see him die right now before this clock runs out, and he will do so. So, ESG, I mean, it's kind of like that missed opportunity, isn't it?
It's good moves from ESG. I mean, they kind of force Epsilon after the pickoff to go middle, but they're kind of securing all the angles. So, Epsilon kind of forced pushing up either through that CPL window room or connector, and they're ready for it.
Yeah, they were this time, although they're holding it sort of passively. I mean, if you see now, I mean, what do you think, Devil War? Because normally you can have a guy all the way in connector, and it feels like ESG are just holding, you know, inside the A bomb site all the way back from almost CT spawn. They're not really actually active.
I'm wondering if that's just, you know, having Delpan on your team, that he's able to take the shots with that AWP.
All right, now they are taking some pretty good shots here. Now it's down to Shoxi. Actually, does pick up a kill quickly, but might be the end of it. FXGO coming up from the middle into connector and will get found. Delpan with a kill, and it's going to be Emilio actually with the triple kill that round. He's up to 20 kills right now. Emilio almost catching up to SF and does catch up to FXGO. What's the plan, Devil Walk? What's the plan here for Epsilon to get some more rounds home? Oh, did we lose him again? I think we did.
Not sure. Let me see. I don't know.
Oh, man.
Ah, man. It's not meant to be. It's not meant to be.
But it is for Delpan. He's going to be picking off Super All Fighter, right. And that just kind of... I mean, that's the kind of pickup they really can't afford here, Epsilon. That's going to make it so tough now.
Well, dude, they're doing what I was going to say, is like Epsilon now are just going for an A smoke round, but they're really taking their time with it, and Delpan is still here. He's going to get the first shot for free, misses the second one. He's going to have an opportunity to get a third, and he will. And this just gets crushed. Epsilon don't really go anywhere after they throw their smokes and flashes, so ESG have all the time in the world to set up.
That they do. Delpan with a triple kill in that round, and there's something cool about the way Delpan plays that exact position, which is interesting. We should try and compare other AWPers to this, because the way Delpan does is he sort of peeks and takes a shot, he kills somebody, then when he's reloading the AWP or sort of getting a new bullet into the chamber, he's actually peeking in between that to sort of pick up his next target. Like, he already knows that there are more people there before he re-peeks and can actually shoot, so that's kind of interesting.
Well, it's like, it's also just him, like, that's a very aggressive position to be holding with an AWP, so again, it's just like a Delpan position is what I'm going to call it, because you wouldn't usually see people holding from there with that AWP like that. Usually you'd see them where Delpan is right now, on stairs, electric, or back in CT spawn, but instead Delpan, he kind of cuts out the CT smoke or the electric smoke, and just takes a very aggressive position where it's like, if he doesn't land the shot, well, he's dead. But then Delpan lands that shot.
Oh, DMX coming up from behind here. If they take down Krithen, it's a big opening. It is a big opening. Right now, they've actually got themselves into a 4-on-2 now. Rogue and Mikey Lele left, and maybe Rogue is going to be the guy to take down SF. If he does that, he can rotate over and help out Mikey Lele. But SF is playing this very slowly, and that's really good right now.
He's really taking his time about it, but right now the rotation is coming off of B site. Roke working his way over to A, and this is the right call. There's already two guys out on this A site, a third one soon to join with the bomb. They're about to get the plant here, Epsilon, and now Roke is trying to rotate in, lend a hand to his teammate, can't turn away at the wrong time, gives a shot away, but still gets the headshot on Shoxi.
Yeah, and now Mikey Lily, I think he, well, they must realize where the bomb is. DMX is caught in a bit of a weird position. Nice pick off here. DMX goes down as well. What on earth is going on? SF now just charging in, but it actually might be just the right timing. They still don't have the defuse. FS is coming up here. They don't know he's here, and he's going to be able to get a free kill on Rogue, and he doesn't take it. This is intelligent play from Super Fighter. Very, very smartly done. He's looking for Mikey Lily as well, and now he's going to shoot and turns around. He doesn't get the kill. Rogue stays alive. That was such a supreme play from Super Fighter. I feel like he should have had that round. Absolute balls of steel to stay alive for that long.
That was so smart as well, because the bomb was planted for him. He knew exactly where Mikey Lily was going to be, so he had one guy, and then he just had to wait to see the other guy. He just had to control the spray. That's all he had to do for the second kill, was just control the spray and bring it home.
Oh man, that's painful, because that's actually one of the coolest plays we've seen in a very long time. If he had run in and just got the kill on Rogue, he definitely would risk winning that one-on-one a whole lot. I think what he did was basically maximize his chances of winning, and he was one bullet away from being able to do it. He definitely deserved to win that round. That is...
What did he live with? Like 5 HP?
Yeah, something like that.
That's brutal. That's just brutal.
Yeah, rounds like that don't actually come around that often, where you see one guy being able to just keep cool like that. It's very, very hard once you're in the game. And obviously, if you just lose, if they just spot him, you're going to feel like the worst player in the whole world, right? Because you just let go of getting a certain kill.
A certain kill, but he's still... I mean, he's got that certain kill. I think what he was worried about more is like where Mikey Lily is. Where's the last guy? And is he going to look towards me? But Mikey Lily, of course, doesn't glance towards CPL. That's what's really sick and made it all possible, is that Mikey Lily doesn't realize it until it's too late, that he's just that SF is standing out in the open like that.
Yeah. Ah. Well, push is going to be happening towards the bomb site again, and as Devil Walks said when he was here, they are sort of forced to push up towards the connector, because if they come up for the slope, there's a good chance to get picked off by Delpan here. Kiyoshima with a good shot, but he goes down. Auto sniper from Khitan, and it's going to be a 1-on-2 for Super Fighter, who did so well last time, but this time there's no sneaky peeky. They know where he is, and Delpan will take him down, and that is now 13-11, and no bomb plant and not that much money. They could buy AKs on 3 people and Galil's on 2, and at this point the question is, do you want to risk it or do you want to try and save? And then, well, there's the answer. No saving.
No fear.
Oh, wait. Okay, I was going to say. So they actually go for C-sets.
That's some money, not updating.
Yeah, no, they go for C-sets instead of Galil's. That's the change I was worried about. But that's all right. I don't think that's a bad choice.
No, just as good. For $300, I mean, you can definitely get some damage done with the CZs. They got nades as well, and that's the big thing. It's like they realize that if they buy the rifles, they're not going to have enough money for full nades. So you do need nades on Mirage, really, to give you a chance. So Epsilon taking the hit, GMX and FX, but we've seen what FX can do. I mean, when he got into that position with Delpan, it was by sneaking up on Delpan with the CZ.
Oh no, FX Joe got off guard there, and Delpan up close takes down GMX, which is unfortunate. They did some good damage early on onto Rogue, burned him down to 50 HP, so it looked like a bit of a better start for Epsilon this time. The big problem is if they lose this upcoming round, well, they're going to have two people who can buy AKs and then everyone else can't. So, but then do they want to... I think they're just going to buy anyway, probably. So we'll see how it goes down.
Let's see, it's going to come down to Shoxi. Well, not necessarily... Roke is not very healthy right now. He does have support from Huiten with that SCAR 20. There you go. Shots going in. That's a lot of damage dealt already. That should be a freebie there for Roke. He's going to manage to team up and pick off SF. Now it's the support raining in, and Roke is somehow going to live through this round. Just fire support from Huiten does it.
Yeah, very good job. That auto sniper has really paid off for him here. I mean, he hasn't had the best game on Mirage here. Huiten, he's at the bottom of the scoreboard, which is not incredible for him. But obviously, you know, now that he's got the ultra sniper, he seems to be locking down that B bomb site and is quite mobile with it as well. That's 14-11, and they will buy up this round, even though it's two AKs yet and three Galils. They feel like they can't really, they don't want to go for the tie. They want to see if they can't bring it all the way back here and win 5 rounds in a row.
Well, it's just, they're getting maximum bonus right now, because that's 7 rounds in a row now for ESG.
Yeah.
So Epsilon, they can afford to buy. If they get a plant, even better, but they can afford to buy every round now for the remainder of this half. This is the big pressure round for ESG, though. They have to just shut this down to get on match point. But I don't think they're too concerned. They've still got a little bit of bank to work with here. But Huiten, aggressive positioning with this SCAR 20. Is SF going to be able to punish him eventually here?
Well, we'll find out soon enough. He is in a pretty tight spot. He's got some help with Rogue as well, and SF is going to be coming in. Two body shots is all it takes for that auto sniper to make short work of you. Now pushing up into the middle here, things are not looking good. FXO goes down. They're now trying a 5-on-3 push towards the B bomb site. Emilio will take a kill on Kirishima. DMX goes down, and it will be down to the lone player here, Shoxi, in a 1-on-5.
With the Galil. All right, Shoxi, let's see it. Not what I was expecting. We put too much pressure on him, Anders. He couldn't handle it.
Now, things are really not looking so good right now. Shoxi's at 16 kills, which is not horrible, but it, compared to his, you know, hard carry role earlier when he was just, you know, dropping massive frags, I think that must be the worst thing about being Shoxi, is when you do that, everyone adores you and you're an absolute god. And then when you do just good, still good, not badly, just good, people are like, what the hell is he doing, you know? Why can't he drop another 40 bomb?
Exactly.
It's hard to win like that.
Well, this is the thing, and it's also why, you know, you can talk about consistency with Shoxi and it being a big problem for him. His ability to sometimes go massive, 30 frags and make it look easy, and then some games just not even really be on the scoreboard at all. It's something to keep in mind. But right now, at least, Epsilon, they're not thinking about that. They're thinking about how to get onto this A site. And that's the thing. They're very limited on nades right now. So it's going to come down to these opening shots. They have to try and close in fast, but Michelele already picks off Shoxi.
And Emilio with some great spray control, and that pretty much shuts everything down here. FXO is going to be dropped, and it will be 16-11 in favor of the Swedes, who just tied against LDLC in a match that I actually think they probably should have lost. But it was a tie. This time it's a win, and that does...